Good morning all. So welcome to the session. So in the previous session we discussed the oscillator circuits, okay? So the basic principle of oscillation, the criteria for Burk oscillation, that is Burkhausen criterion, the loop gain should be unity and the angle of A into beta should be equal to 0 degree or 360 degree. That is the main criteria. Based on that, we have seen the first category of oscillator, that is RC phase shift oscillator. So in this, you will be having an amplifier circuit along with a RC frequency selective network, that is three cascaded sections of resistor and capacitor combination. So based on that, you have seen the op amp based oscillator, okay? And we didn't have the much analysis on that, but now what we are discussing is FET based phase shift oscillator. So it's a detailed analysis, and oscillator means what? We will generating a waveform. So it's waveform frequency we are going to measure it, okay? Practically we will measure the frequency from the CRO, but theoretically we will derive the equation for frequency, okay? So that we try to do. I have shown you already the circuit to you, okay? So further analysis we will do it, okay? So it is a self-biased amplifier, okay? And the so this is the circuit I have shown. Let's revise. So this is the your FET, okay? So it is a junction FET. You have went through this device, okay? So just same as MOSFET, okay? So but it is same way, okay? So there is no much difference, but characteristics or its equation is different, okay? When you are considering the drain current and all, okay? In the source side, it is having a source resistance and bypassed with a capacitor, and you have the RD here. And then it is having the frequency selector. This is the feedback network. So output will be taken across the drain. So here the three cascaded sections are connected. So CR, and then its output, that is 180 degree output phase shift, will be given as series with the gate. Okay. So this is the section. So we need to do the analysis. To do the analysis, we have to go in the same manner, okay? So just we'll see how we to proceed, okay? So just little bit, the same thing will be explained in the next slide. As shown, the feedback voltage VF, okay, available at the output of the last RC section of the feedback network is fed to the gate as input, okay? So that is the point. As the FET amplifier provides a phase shift of 180 degree. So I told you, any amplifier if you use, it is giving a phase shift of 180 degree. For positive cycle, it will give negative cycle. It may be you use op amp, FET, BJT, any amplifier. So they are non-linear, okay? So it is giving a 180 degree phase shift, okay? To satisfy the Burkhausen criteria, remaining 180 degree phase shift, you have to bring it from the feedback network, okay? The remaining 180 degree phase shift has to be provided by the feedback network to obtain a total phase shift of 360 degree around the loop, okay? To satisfy the Burkhausen criteria. If it does not satisfy, the oscillation will not generate at all, okay? That is the reason. Thus, each RC section is designed so as to provide a phase shift of 60 degree. So each RC section, orally, we will say everything, every RC section will give 60 degree exactly, okay? At the desired frequency of oscillation. But in practice, what happens, no? The sections do not provide a phase shift of exactly 60 degree, okay? It will not happen exactly 60 degree each RC section due to the loading of one RC section on the previous one. So you have CR, CR, okay? So that R will act as the load, it will reduce the phase shift, okay? Because of that, so how it is designed is at the output, okay? At the output side, it will give 180 degree, as I told you previously also. The first RC section may give you more than 60 degree, okay? Then the second one will give you less than the first one, and finally it is less than the previous one. Finally, at the output, it is giving the total multiplied, no? So both all the three angles are added, it will come 180 degree, okay? So that is what told. What is required is a total phase shift of 180 degree, okay, from the feedback network. So that is what we are going to achieve from the network, okay? So this analysis of this FET amplifier is not in detail. Okay, the equations are directly written. So, but I have tried to solve it and bring it in front of you. So that's why be careful about this analysis. Okay. So we will now compute the loop gain. Okay, loop gain A beta from the AC equivalent circuit given in figure. So that's why in the module one we have learnt all these things. Okay, if an amplifier is given, how we write the small signal equivalent circuit, all these things. Okay, the same thing we are going to do for now the FET also. So FET will be replaced by its model and then remaining resistor whatever you know. Okay, so that we try to show it here in the figure. For this we will assume that the input impedance of the FET amplifier stage is infinite. Okay, so as like MOSFET, this FET amplifier is also giving input impedance infinite. Okay, so that's why the FET model will look like this. Okay, so see here G, S, okay, and this. So in the case of your MOSFET, we have shown this as R0. Okay, RO, here it is shown as RD. Okay, because you are not studied the junction FET part in this AC, maybe you have went through or you have to refer. Okay, so now this is the reference. Here only I am going to show you. And GM will be there, transconductance, and the dependent voltage, okay, VI. So VI is nothing but the input voltage. Okay, so this will be taken as gate to source voltage sometimes. In this example, because this is an amplifier to show, I have taken this as VI, and this output of this amplifier stage is called as V0, and that output amplifier stage we have connected the three RC sections, and then output of that will be VF, and this output only will be given as input to the gate. Okay, but in AC equivalent circuit that part will not come, it will come as a this type of shape. Okay, so beginning you have the MOSFET model. So then this is the drain resistor. VDD will be short circuited. RD will come in parallel with the this RD, internal resistance. Okay, so here we'll measure the V0. Okay, and then the same whatever you have CR, so that we are going to write it over here. Okay, so next what we will do, so we'll be doing some simplification. Okay, so we have here a current source and a resistor. Okay, so and this is the RD dash. We can consider these two are in parallel. We can consider it as RD dash, or we can consider this current source into an equivalent voltage source. We have learned in network theory, right? So that we try to do in the next step. Okay, because there are many loops are there, just try to reduce the loop so that we can apply the mesh analysis. Okay, for the analysis. So here it will give you a clear picture how we are going to further proceed with the analysis. Okay, again it is quite difficult to understand beginning. Okay, slowly you will understand this as you write it. So figure E can be further simplified as shown in figure F. Here the current source is replaced by the equivalent voltage source. Okay, so it is given as GM VI was there already. For that now RD dash is multiplied. Okay, so directly one step I have done it. Okay, so what I have done, RD dash is nothing but RD parallel with RD dash, and that I have clubbed with the current source. Okay, so that becomes now voltage source into series with resistance. Because of that, the two loops are reduced here and became a single loop. Okay, so further we could not simplify because there is a CR section came here. So here you have the output. Okay, so this I will consider. What happened in us? Okay. Okay. I hope you have understood this. So here RD and capital RD both were in parallel. So that is replaced by a single resistor RD dash. Okay. RD dash is nothing but RD parallel with RD, and that RD dash in parallel with current source was there that I converted into a voltage source. Okay, GM VI into RD dash. Okay, because voltage is nothing but current into resistance, right? Then RD dash in comes in series, and remaining it is as it is there. So now we will assume the loop currents. Okay, so first loop I will call I1, second loop I2, and third loop I3. Okay, so now what I am going to do here is, so this is the lapless network we will consider. So you know, right? In everything in network theory and control system, we'll be using Laplace transform. It is better for us to understand, right? So we'll be applying that. So capacitor becomes 1 by Cs, and R will be there as it is. Okay, so first we'll try to write the three equations, I1, I2, I3 involving three loop equations we'll write, and then we'll do the further analysis. Okay, in your textbook, whatever I shown you, microelectronic circuits, so there they have given only the three equations, okay, the loop equations they have shown, and afterwards directly they have given the frequency. Okay, so you'll not understand from that book. Okay, so I have tried to solve here, so hope we'll see, so hope you will understand. Okay, so first on the equation, now the loop equation, so what will come, so I will write it in Laplace transform again, I told you. Okay, so here you have minus to plus, anyhow you can consider. Okay, gm rd dash vi into this is the voltage, then I1 rd dash, then here 1 by cs is there. Okay, so 1 by cs into I1, and then here r I1 minus I2. So you know the loop analysis how to apply, the same thing I'm doing. So then next case, okay, second loop, so it is I2 minus I1 R, and then C in 1 by CS into I2, and then R into I2 minus I3. And finally at the I3 you have the R I3 minus I2, 1 by CS into I3, R into I3. There is no further loop here, so that's R into I3. And then fourth equation will be your this one, okay, VF is equal to, what is the current in this branch? I3. I3 into R becomes the VF. So using these four equations, we are trying to derive the frequency of oscillations of the RC phase shift oscillator. Okay. So that is what the analysis. So I hope till here there is no doubt to you. Okay. So now we'll see the equation part. Okay. So diagram is till here. Okay. So the whatever I told you there, the same thing I have written down here, okay, and in grouped manner, okay. So I have, since it is a this one, okay, non-planar network, so directly I have applied. So first loop, what are the impedances connected? R and 1 by SC, grouped it, okay. So I1 was the current in that, and the mutual was R. So minus I2 into R I have made equal to minus GM RD dash VI. Okay, so it is the reverse to the our conventional one. Okay, so when you write the equation, it was there plus, if you take right side, it becomes minus, right? So like that. Then second loop, the mutual to first loop was R, right? So minus I1, okay, minus sign I1 into R. Then self loop, so you have two resistors in the second loop, that's why 2R, R plus R, 2R plus 1 by SC, capacitor is there, into I2. And then again at the I3 side, you have another resistor. So minus I3R, there is no voltage source here, that's why zero. And then similarly, we'll go to loop three. So where R is mutual to two, second loop. So minus I2R plus self loop, you have again two resistors. Okay, that's why R plus R, it becomes 2R plus 1 by SC capacitor is there, into I3 is equal to zero. Okay, so it is equation three. And finally, I told you the feedback voltage VF is nothing but I3 current into R. Okay. So these are the four equations. Okay. So I hope this should be clear to you. Okay. These equations. Okay. So you can apply the analysis in two ways. Okay. So this way is easy. When you have such a planar network, okay, you can easily apply the loop. Okay. Self loop, what are the resistances connected? Okay. RD dash R. And 1 by CS. Okay. And this GM RD dash VI. So here RD dash is neglected because it is told that compared to this R value, RD dash is very small. So that's why it is neglected, not considered. Okay. That's why R and C is considered and this voltage source is considered. Okay. So it is shown in the figure. Okay. You can ask why RD dash is not there. It is assumed it is not having much significance. It may simply complicate the analysis. Okay. Fine. Okay. So then this loop, two resistors and one capacitor in self. Okay. And this resistor is in mutual, and here this resistor is mutual with loop three. And when it comes to loop three, two resistors again and one capacitor. Okay. And finally VF. Hope it is clear. So now we'll go to do the analysis. Okay. So now what I will do is one by one, I will try to bring the equation. Okay. Because I have I1, I2, I3, three equations I have. So using these four equations, what I have to do is I have to form a single equation now. Okay, so single equation in the sense you should have one side feedback voltage, another side you should have input voltage Vi. So what we will get? Loop gain. We have to derive the loop gain, that is A beta. Okay, so that how you will get the ratio of Vf by Vi. Vf is the output voltage, Vi is the input voltage. So voltage gain. Okay, so that voltage gain to get, I need to club all the four equations. Okay, so how we will do that? That is the step now. Okay, so first thing, so what we'll do, we'll divide the equation by R. Okay, one by one. First I will consider the equation 3. So I will divide equation 3 by R. So this R will cancel out, and here this R will cancel out, and here R will come in the denominator. Okay, so then what I will do, wherever, sorry for the inconvenience. Okay. If some call comes, it will cut. Okay. Fine. Visible now. Okay. So I'm going to do one by one because I will consider equation 3 because, so in equation 1, I have 3 terms here. I1 is there, I2 is there, and then Vi is there. Okay. If I consider second equation here, I1, I2, I3, I could not substitute for any of these variable. But when I considered here third equation, I2R equal to this, if I make, I can get some substitution here. So that I3 I can substitute, or I2 I can substitute in the equation 2. Okay, so by substituting here for I2 or I3, I will get here equation for I1 relating to I2, and then finally I can put that equation in equation 1, so that I will get finally a single equation. Okay, so that I am trying to do. Okay, and this part is not shown in book. Okay, your textbook it is not shown. I have personally solved it. Okay, so remember this equation. Okay, so what I am using it. Okay, and then another thing is I will be substituting s equal to j omega. Okay, because I need to calculate the frequency. You know, frequency is in s, right? S is given by the real part plus imaginary part. Okay, the real part will be zero, only imaginary part we are considering. So we'll substitute wherever s is there j omega. Okay, so wherever s is there in this equation, I will substitute j omega. First I will do simplification, then I will substitute j omega. Okay, so wherever here s is there, I will substitute j omega. Okay, so from that only I will get the frequency part. Okay, okay, first I have considered equation 3 now. So I have divided the whole equation by R. So minus I2 R was there, so it becomes minus I2. Then I3 2 R was there, so 2 was there, and R will come in this second part denominator. So equal to 0. Next, what I will do, I will substitute s equal to j omega. So I2. So this I2 is minus, right? So if I take this right side, it will become plus. And if you rearrange the equation, what you will get? I2 is equal to I3 into 2 plus, where s is there, I have substituted j omega. Okay, into CR. So next, I2 equal to I3 2. So this divide by j is there, no? I will take it in the numerator. So you have plus 1 by j. So if you want to take the numerator, so this is equivalent to minus j, you know, from the normal mathematics, right? So 1 by j is equivalent to minus j. So that's what I have done here. So this plus sign was went because of this j was taken in the numerator. Okay, minus j by omega CR. So remember this, whatever I'm doing in this first equation, you remember the same thing we are going to do for remaining two equations also. Okay. So next what I will do, so this 1 by omega CR, I will substitute as alpha. Okay, I will take some variable, any variable you can consider. If I does not consider, it is very difficult for me. Every time I need to write 1 by omega CR, 1 by omega CR. Okay, because it is capacitor part, no? And every equation I will be dividing by R. Okay, so that's why I will put it as an variable alpha, and finally I will use that alpha. Okay, so to get it. So now the equation becomes I2 is equal to I3 2 minus J. This is 1 by omega CR is alpha. So that's why it will come J alpha. Okay. So this is your equation 5a. Okay, I am doing the simplification, right? So call it as 5a equation. Okay, I hope this part is clear. So first I have divided by r, then wherever s is there j omega I have substituted, then I have done 1 by j equal to minus j substitution, and then I have taken 1 by omega cr as alpha, and that I have substituted. That's it. Okay, similarly we'll do it for equation 2 now. Okay, and we'll use this equation 5a also in that. Okay, to get the new value of I2. Now we'll equation 2 we will divide by r. So where you had I1, I2, I3, again same way. So you'll get I1r is I1. Okay, then I2, 2r was there, so 2 will come. Here you had the r, it will come in the denominator. Okay, and minus I3r was there, so r will cancel, I3 will come. Okay, so this is the first substitution. Second thing, so what we will do, directly I have written now. Okay, I hope you will understand this. S is there, I have substituted j omega, same thing you will get. Okay, so you can do this. S is there, j omega I have substituted, then 1 by j it will come, minus j by what will come, minus j by omega cr, that 1 by omega cr is alpha, so that's why I have written directly I2 2 minus j alpha. Hope it is understood. And minus I1 minus I3 is there. If I take right side, it will become I1 plus I3. Clear? The same step what I have done previously. Okay. So first thing, R I have divided, then S I have substituted j omega, then 1 by j I have considered minus j. That's why it will become minus sine. And then 1 by omega cr, omega cr I will substitute as alpha. I have taken, no, already. So that I do, so this equation becomes 2 minus j alpha. This complete part, it becomes 2 minus j alpha. And then I1, I3, these are minus sign are there. If I take right side, it will become plus sign. So I1 plus I3 will come. Hope it is understood. Okay. So next what I will do, I have already a equation 5a previously I have done. Okay, which is relating I2 and I3. So what I will do is, in this place of I2, I will substitute that I3 value. Okay, so that I am trying to do. Okay, what will happen, see. So what is I2 value from equation 5a? It is I3 into 2 minus j alpha. Okay, into this 2 minus j alpha is there now, whatever it is there, equal to I1 plus I3. Clear? Equation 5a we have done previously, that I have substituted for I2, which is I3 into 2 minus j alpha, then remaining here 2 minus j alpha is there, equal to I1 plus I3. So now, since here I3 is there, so this I3 I will take it this side. Okay, it will become minus, right? So this I3 I will take it this side, and I will rearrange the equation. I will form it for finding I1. So I1 I have taken here. So I3, this part. So 2 minus j alpha twice it is there. So it's a square I will write, minus this I3 I have taken this side, no? This one. Okay, minus I3. So next I will solve this square. I1 equal to, I3 is common in both the cases. Okay, so common, then it, this is a square, a minus b whole square. Okay, a square is 2 square, it is 4, then b square, plus b means j alpha square. So j square means what, minus 1, because of that it is minus sign comes, and alpha square, minus 2ab, 2 into 2, 4, 4j alpha or j4 alpha. Okay, so that is j4 alpha written. Minus this I3, because I3 is taken common now here, that's why minus 1 will come here, and 4 minus 1 it becomes 3. So that's what written, I1 is equal to I3, 4 minus 1 becomes 3, then remaining as it is written, minus alpha square minus j4 alpha. I call this as equation 5d. Equation 5a was relating I2 and I3, and equation 5b is relating I1 and I3, so that now I can use this everything in the equation 1 now. Okay, so we'll go to equation 1, same analysis we'll do, we'll divide by r, substitute s equal to j omega, and then we'll 1 by omega cr will substitute as alpha, you will get this form of equation. In that equation you will substitute these 5a and 5b relation. Okay, so I will be sending the notes after this so that you will understand. Okay, when you are writing. So similarly I'm doing the analysis for equation 1 now. Okay, again directly I am doing I1 1 plus 1 by SCR. Okay, so it is I1 was common, R plus this one was there, 1 by SC was there. So it will come 1 plus SCR minus I2 R was there. So it is I2, then minus GM. Here also I am dividing, no? Previous two equations, 0 was there. 0 by R is 0 only. But now right side, there is a terms are there. That's why I have to consider minus GM RD dash by R VI. Okay. So see here, VI I have got here in equation. Somehow for the left side, I should get now VF. Okay. The feedback voltage I should get. If the equation becomes lengthy now, all I am clubbing now. Okay. And forming a single equation from the four equation. And finally, I'm taking the ratio VF by VI, which will give you the gain. Okay. So simple. Okay. Just to see. So now again, wherever S is there, I have substituted J omega, and then 1 by J becomes minus J, and 1 by omega CR is alpha. Okay. So that's why this complete pattern, okay, this complete, it will reduce it to 1 minus alpha. Okay. So there is 1 minus J alpha, it will come. Okay. I1 minus I2 equal to minus GM RD dash R by R into VI. It is same, only this. Now next, what we have to do? We have to substitute for I1 and I2 from equation 5a and 5b. Okay. Because we know I1 is relating I3 and I2 is relating I3. Equation 5b and 5a. Right. So that we put it here. What will happen? See. So what was the value of I1 from equation 5b? Okay. So it is I3 into 3 minus alpha square minus J4 alpha. Right. That I have substituted. Into 1 minus J alpha already there, that you have to write, minus I2 from equation 5a. Again, first equation, what was the answer? I3 into 2 minus J alpha. Substituted equal to minus GM RD dash R into VI. Okay. So we'll try to simplify this. Okay. Everything will multiply and we'll try to simplify. So both equation I3 is common here. So I will take I3 outside. And then I will put a big bracket, okay, and we'll do all analysis now. So we'll start with this equation. I will multiply this each term with this term, okay, 1 minus J alpha, because this is a multiplication here, right? So you have to multiply here. So 3 into 1 is 3. Then 3 into, next what I have considered, minus alpha square into 1 I have taken. Anyhow, you can multiply, okay? So minus alpha square. Then minus J4 alpha into 1. Minus J4 alpha. Okay. Then you have this. Okay. Minus. So minus 3 J alpha into 3 minus J3 alpha. J term normally will write first. Okay. Then minus alpha square minus J alpha. So what will be happening? So minus minus it becomes plus. Okay. So it is happening plus here. And then J will be there. Okay. So J term is there and alpha square and alpha alpha cube. Clear? So this multiplication, complete multiplication is over now. Coming to minus, this term we will consider. Okay. So it is something happened here. 1, 2 minus J alpha. Okay. Still some more is there. Okay. Fine. Multiplication is not over. This part is there, right? Minus J4 alpha into this one, minus J alpha. Okay, what will happen here? JJ is there, J square, minus minus plus was there first, but J square is minus 1 because of that minus sign it will retain. Okay, and 4 alpha into alpha, 4 alpha square. Very carefully you have to do when you have J term. Okay, J into J is J square, but J cube will not be, J cube will be minus J. So these some terms you know. Okay, I shown you previously 1 by J equal to minus J and then J square is equal to minus 1. Okay, because J value is square root of minus 1, right? So J square is minus 1. Careful. Okay, so here J square minus 1 because of this, it will not become plus. Okay, minus only it will retain. And then finally you have this minus of 2 minus 2 and minus into minus plus J alpha. So everything is clubbed now. So now we have to group all the cube terms, real part terms and J part terms. Okay. Right side, nothing changes as it is, it will hold. So next, what we have here is anything you can simplify, you have to check. Okay. Here 3 is their constant and here you have minus 2, 3 minus 2 becomes 1. Okay. then here minus alpha square is there, here minus 4 alpha square is there. Okay, so this forms the real part. Then comes the imaginary part, j terms. So alpha cube is only one term is there, it will be there, whereas j alpha term three are there here, minus j4 alpha, minus j3 alpha, minus j7 alpha, plus j alpha, it is minus j6 alpha you will get. Okay, so j alpha is common, so minus 4, minus 3, minus 7, plus 1, minus 6, no, so that is j part. So that equation I am writing next. Time is running. Okay, we'll see. So this is what final. Okay, real part and imaginary part are separated. I3 common, so one you got, 3 minus 2, and this minus alpha square, minus 4 alpha square, minus 5 alpha square you got. This real part plus then j terms will club, so you have alpha cube and then minus 6 alpha. Okay, equal to this term. So next we'll use the equation 4. From equation 4 you know that vf is equal to I3 into r. So you'll substitute for I3 is Vf by R. So I have substituted here Vf by R, remaining things as it is. Okay. So here this denominator R and this denominator R will cancel out. Okay. And hence the loop gain A beta of the oscillator circuit. So you'll take the ratio of Vf and this Vi I will take in the denominator. Okay. Denominator of Vi. So what is remaining? In the numerator remaining Gm into Rd dash, divided by this whole term will be there in the denominator, 1 minus 5 alpha square plus j alpha cube minus 6 alpha. Okay, make it as equation 6. So previous to 5a 5b I have written, after this equation 6. So this is very important equation. So from this only we are able to find now next terms. Okay, so to get the frequency of oscillation, always remember, because frequency is there in the imaginary part, so you have to make imaginary part equal to 0. So you will get some equation, from that you can calculate the frequency of oscillation. Okay. Okay. As loop gain is a real quantity, so you'll make imaginary part is equal to 0. Okay. So loop gain is always a real quantity. So only real quantity if we keep. So you'll make the imaginary part 0. So what we'll get? Alpha cube minus 6 alpha was the imaginary part. So this we will equate to 0. Okay, so what will happen, you can solve it in this manner also. Okay, or else what you can do, alpha cube is equal to 6 alpha, right? Like this also you can write. If I take minus 6 alpha right side, what will happen? It will become 6 alpha. Okay, so this is the better way, so don't use this. Okay, okay, I have written this. Okay, you can change this. Alpha cube minus 6 alpha equal to 0. 6 alpha I have taken right side, it will come. So 1 alpha it will cancel out here. So it becomes alpha square is equal to 6. What is alpha square? Alpha we have substituted 1 by omega cr. Now I am taking this back. Okay. Alpha is nothing but 1 by omega cr. Okay. And we are taken alpha square there. That's why it is omega square c square r square. So you can write like this, or you can write omega cr is equal to 1 by alpha, right? So in that manner it is 1 by 6. Okay, so alpha square is 1 by omega square r square 6 c square equal to 6. Directly what I have written, omega square r square c square is equal to 1 by 6. This I have taken in the denominator. To bring this in numerator, I have taken this 1 6 in the denominator. So equation is equated. So now you can find the omega. Okay, omega is our focus here. So that's what we have got. Okay, so what we will do, omega square is equal to 1 by r square c square. This r square c square I will take it in the denominator, multiply with 6, and then omega is nothing but square root of that answer. Okay, and again you know omega is equal to, omega is in angular frequency, if you convert this in hertz it is 2 phi f. Okay, so 2 phi f if you substitute, so the 2 phi term will again come in the denominator. So this is how we will be getting the things. Okay, the frequency of oscillation becomes directly given. Okay, so omega is equal to, I told you, r square c square into 6, it will come. Omega is nothing but 1 by r square c square, it becomes rc, 6 becomes square root of 6. Okay, understood? and then f is equal to omega by 2 phi, right? So omega is this value, 2 phi it will come. So this is the frequency. So in lab when we are using, we'll use this equation to get the theoretical frequency, and you have to match with the practical value what you are observing in the CRO. So this is the any of the RC phase shift oscillator general equation of frequency, it will come. Even if you use the BJT, almost same type you will get, little some factors it will add up. So this is the equation, 2 phi RC square root of 6. So remember this. So then equation 5 becomes, so when you substitute this, we are going to substitute the values now. What value? The alpha value. Alpha square is equal to 6 we got now. That 6 we are substituting in the equation 6. Equation 5. So just which is equation, just quickly go back. So from this, I'm going to give you the condition. Equation mistake. Six equation it is. So here what I will do, I will substitute the alpha square value. It is 6, no? So what will happen? It is 6. So this is 0 we have made. 0 we have made and we have got the frequency. Now alpha square value is 30. 6. 6 into 5 is 30. 1 minus 30 is minus 29. So minus 29, minus, cancel out, So 29 will be there in the denominator, or if we consider magnitude also, we will not consider the minus sign. So that's how the minus come there. GMRD dash by 29. See here, minus minus sign cancel out. So this is the magnitude of the loop gain, because this is also should be greater than one. One of the criteria. One is 180 degree phase shift criteria. Another is loop gain should be one. So you have to make this one means what? A beta greater than one for sustained oscillation. So what we'll do, GMRD dash should be greater than 29. So this factor is one, meaning what? GMRD dash is greater than 29. Its value should be greater than 29. Only then you will get the oscillations. So this is what you will get, A greater than GMRD dash or A greater than 29. Or beta equal to 1 by 29. This is the factor. Because of that, you will get A beta equal to 1. So we'll consider in the next class, further analysis.